Hey everyone, let's do a general overview of Procreate's features and tools. When you open Procreate, you'll first see the gallery. This is where all your artworks are stored. You can open artworks by tapping on them, or you can work with a new canvas by tapping on the plus button here. In this menu, you have the option of selecting a canvas size from this list or creating a custom size for your canvas. For this example, I'll go with the screen size canvas, which will open up a new drawing area. Let's look at the three primary tools up here on the top right, with all three containing the same default brushes. First, we have the brush tool. Brushes here are organized into categories on the left, and the brushes within each category are displayed on the right. And in addition to default brushes, you can also create, organize, and edit your own brushes. If you'd like to know how to create your own brushes in Procreate, I'll leave a tutorial link for you in the comments area. Secondly, we have the smudge tool, which allows you to smudge colors or parts of your artwork. And thirdly, we have the erase tool. The next tool is layers, which looks simple at first glance. However, there are a lot of useful tools neatly tucked away within layers. The tool on the right is the colors tool. When opened, you'll first be presented with the color wheel. However, you can explore the five color tabs down here. This is designed to offer artists multiple color interfaces, which gives us a variety of options to choose, save, and adjust colors that best work for us. If you're interested in how to make your own color palettes, I'll leave a tutorial link for you down in the comments. Let's have a look at the sliders here. The top slider controls the brush size, and the bottom slider controls the opacity. There's also the modify button in between the sliders. This can be used to trigger different tools. Let's talk about brush pressure variation for a moment. Artists are able to use a finger and other styluses to draw within Procreate. However, brush pressure variation is best with the use of the Apple Pencil. I'm using a custom brush from my watercolor set to demonstrate brush pressure. The more pressure I draw with the Apple Pencil, the thicker the stroke. If you're interested in this brush, you can find the link to the watercolor brush set in the comments area. At the bottom here is the undo and redo buttons. We can also do the same with our fingers. You can undo by tapping with two fingers and redo by tapping with three. You can scrub with three fingers to clear a layer you're currently working on. The copy and paste menu can also be accessed by swiping down with three fingers. Full screen mode can be turned on and off by tapping with four fingers. You can also pinch, zoom, rotate, and reposition the canvas. Additionally, you can fit canvas to screen with a quick pinch and reverse pinch to return to the most recent position. You can also tap and briefly hold with a finger to pick up a color. Now let's look at the tools on the top left. Here we have the transform tool. This allows us to select contents of our current layer and bring up a toolbar at the bottom of your canvas to help you make any adjustments. Flip and warp are just some examples. Next is the selections tool, which you can use to isolate parts of your art for repainting or for editing. You can also use it to transform your images as well. A basic example of the selection tool here allows you to cut around images. I have a detailed tutorial demonstrating this in the comments area. The adjustments tool allows you to polish your artwork and helps you create professional effects for your images. There are a lot of effects such as blur, liquify, color gradients, and glitch. Then we have the actions tool. There's a lot you can do within actions. You can add images and also add text to your artwork. You can edit your canvas as well as share images and layers. You can record time-lapse videos and also customize your interface and your touch controls as well. And here we have the gallery button. Tapping on this will take us back to the gallery and most importantly, saves the artwork we were just working on. Don't forget to check the useful links in the comments, subscribe, and thanks for watching.